Hi, welcome to the session. Today we'll discuss about enterprise risk management in our session 2. Enterprise risk management. Enterprise risk management. In FRM, we are going to discuss ERM, enterprise risk management. In the previous session, we discussed about different types of risks that are faced by an organization. An organization, whether it is small or big, will face many different types of risks. Risk management is a process wherein you identify the risks, you prioritize them, then we take an action on risk management by taking controls over it. Then we monitor that whether the risk management techniques are effective or not. So this, the objective of risk management is to eliminate, if possible, or reduce.
Sir, voice is breaking, sir.
So we develop policies and procedures, which we call it as SOP, standard operational procedures. Consists of various activities with an objective to eliminate the risk. If possible, we'll at least reduce the risk. Risk can be a finance risk, can be a business risk, operational risk, or non-operational risk. Now, in the enterprise risk management, ERM, in which we discuss the risk matters at various levels of the organization. Various levels of the organization include at industry level, at its unit level, subunit level. At all the levels of the organization, we identify the risks and take an action to control the risk. And it has become mandatory to control the risk for every public limited company. In most of the countries, it has become the compliance to identify the risk and take measures to control the risk. In a committee of a sponsored organization, COSO, Committee of Sponsored Organizations. This committee formed an integrated framework for the risk management of different companies. Risk management of different companies has become mandatory. By reducing the risk, we can assure the stakeholders that yes, we can fight against the risk. We can safeguard the interest of the stakeholders. So these risk management activities have to be very effective. If not, the effectiveness of the controls which we have to be monitored from time to time. And any ineffective activities are to be questioned, whether they are to be discontinued or we can make them efficient. Enterprise risk management includes a process which consists of planning, organizing, leading and control of all the activities of an organization. The activities can be purchasing, can be selling, can be customer service, can be operations within the organization, can be maintaining the compliance. All these activities may have risk. So we need to have a proper planning to control the risk in the activities carried out by the organization. Elimination of the risk is not possible. We cannot give guarantee that having controls in the organization, we can eliminate complete risk, but at least we can minimize the risk. we can reduce the risk. In each and every activity, we need to identify the risk areas and find out how to reduce the risk, which will not have a bad impact on the capital of the company and profits of the company. As you identify the risks in the industry, in our organization, you take action to control the risks, to mitigate the risks. But what amount of cost you are incurring to control the cost is an important thing. So the benefit what we receive by having the controls is to be compared with the cost incurred to control the risk. Costs and benefits are to be analyzed, which we call it as cost benefit analysis. In a day-to-day operations of the organization, we need to check that what type of risk the companies are facing, and how to control that risk by spending money, cost, and what is the benefit we are receiving from that. Okay, so once you understand the cost benefit analysis, you will come to know whether we should take an action on controlling the risk or we'll have to accept the risk. The benefits after implementing the risk management system in the company, what a company enjoys, include the effectiveness of the business operations. The business operations are carried out efficiently so that we can safeguard the interest of the stakeholders, and more effective risk transfer, in a sense, how the risk is identified and transferred, like taking insurance or sharing the risk with some other companies, like hedging process, and what measures you have taken to control the risk, reporting on risk. It is mandatory for limited companies for the setting up of internal controls and reporting to the organizations from time to time. And overall, the efficiency of the business operations can be improved. The performance can be improved so that it will not have an impact on the earnings. These are the benefits of risk management enterprise level. Who have to participate in the risk management? Participants or the responsible people for the risk management include board of directors, management, top management, especially in the case of banks, etc., in trading room management, dealing room, we call it as, like, setting up the orders, closing the orders, etc., operations, finance, and the risk management team. Not only that, each and every person working for a company, for working for an organization, should be made responsible for the risk management. So the top tone at the top, we call it as, is board of directors, senior management. We set the rules, we set the principles, we follow, and we want our department managers to follow that. This is what we call it as tone at the top. So the participant of ERM includes board of directors, management, especially in the case of trading room management, in the case of placing orders, closing the orders, etc., operations, production, finance, risk management team, etc., all participants of enterprise risk management. Board of directors, in fact, is, we call it as tone at the top, because they are the representatives of the shareholders. They are the responsible person for risk management here. Board of directors have to take responsibility for the risk management. This is the reason why we call it as control environment, the environment of the organization. Environment of the organization become stronger as the board of directors show their interest in the policies and procedures of the company. So as the board of directors play a key role in maintaining the strict environment, that will reflect in the policies and procedures of the company. The other, strong boards include the various other departments, department managers who take care of the shareholders' interest, which include, giving independence to the managers to take, the risk management activities, and also limiting the management ability to assume the risk. Like, there will be some controls to what extent we can accept the risk. Risk appetite means absorbing the risk. So we need to define a risk appetite framework, and within that the manager should act. And we need to have establish a compensation committee in case of the risk, to what extent we can accept the risk, and to what maximum extent we can accept the risk, and beyond that, anybody accept the risk, he is punishable. We should establish an audit committee with the goal of ensuring the financial statements that are presented fairly and objectively. Say, for example, here we have an internal audit system. Our internal auditors conduct auditing here in our department, managers, senior managers, board of directors, etc. So the internal auditing system may be influenced by this department, because most of the internal audit is conducted by the same company staff members. So in that case, the chief audit executive here may not get the independence to report any wrong findings here. So the audit committee should be established, and which is independent from the board and management, so that the chief audit executive can bypass the reporting and report it to audit committee. So the audit committee here is independent body, different from board of directors, which safeguard the interest of the shareholders. So if any internal audit function finds wrongdoing here, can bypass this reporting and report it to audit committee. And audit committee looks after the financial reporting, that no fraudulent financial reporting is presented by the management. So audit committee, by appointing an external auditor, improves the fair financial reporting and approving of all major transactions. So that what happens is the risk can be mitigated, and we can safeguard the interest of our shareholders. Now, participants of the enterprise risk management include board of directors. Board of director is a tone at the top, means the highest participant in ERM, tone at top. So the board of directors should make the rules and follow. Therefore, the other management will follow, like senior management, for approving the business plans, targets, etc. To what extent we can tolerate the risk, means whether we should accept the risk or we should avoid the risk, we should transfer the risk, we should absorb the risk, etc. And establishing the policies and procedures for the company, and responsible for the performance of the company. Risk management department, risk management team, develop the risk policies to mitigate the risk, monitoring of the compliance, that what compliance we need to maintain, how to meet the compliance, managing the risk committee process, validating the models developed, and independent view of the risks, means the risk management is not to be influenced by others. In all the cases, these people should have to be independent. The participants have to be independent, and the ultimate goal of the participants is to mitigate the risk. Trading room management, establishing the risk exposures, to what extent we can accept the risk in the trading room. Then responsible for deal capture, to accept, to close, stop loss, etc. Sign off official P&L account, profit and loss account, etc. Then operations, books and settled, booking and settling the trades, reconciliation of the office positions, front office, back office positions, daily P&L, okay, mark to market adjustment of the positions. Develop individual valuation here, valuation and financial policies in finance department. Ensure the integrity, means the trustworthiness of the profit and loss account, that the financial reporting is made fairly. No artificial information is included here. And business planning running process. So all these stakeholders will have to maintain a risk management with an objective to mitigate the risk. Say for example here, corporate governance. Corporate governance, we should have these best practices, to what extent we should accept the risk and to what extent we should avoid the risk, etc. By having an independent auditors, we set the policies to face the risk. And challenges include that, how to communicate the risk, how to reduce the risk, how to control in various stages. Product line management, like line managers, are to be made responsible. They should be made responsible for independent check. Independent check means verification, like we have prepared by, verified by, authorized by. Portfolio management, quantification process, strategies to be applied for the risk management areas. Risk strategy, we need to have a good strategy to have the cost benefit analysis. What is the cost incurred to mitigate the risk and what benefit we are receiving from that? Risk analytics, like how the risk is to be mitigated. What kind of risks we need to analyze and take an action to mitigate it. Data technology, now standards used in various places to identify the risk and control it. Stakeholder management, there are many stakeholders with lots of different interests, like employment, of secured employment, growth in the company, investor, return on investment, etc. So the effective and transparent communication should be there. A stakeholder like shareholder, the transparent information should be there to the shareholder. An investor, we should make the financial reports very transparent to make the investor happy that yes, the investment is made like this and we can expect the return on investment like this. So both internal and external shareholders should have a proper communication from the company. The process in establishing the risk enterprise risk management begins with, to what extent we can accept the risk, which is establishing the risk appetite framework. To what extent? Risk appetite means to what extent we can digest the risk. Okay, so once you identify the risk, once we identify the risks, we need to establish a framework for risk appetite, to what extent we can mitigate or avoid or transfer the risk. So we need to identify the individual risks here, quantify them, then take a strategy to react on the risk exposed, whether to avoid, transfer, mitigate, assume. Then once you apply any strategy among these, then monitor
monitor from time to time. This is a continuing process. Based on this, you can take again as an action to establish again a risk appetite framework so that we can now take an action that either transfer or mitigate or assume.